Okay. So, Yurifis just won two races in a row in Azerbaijan Grand Prix, in Baku, obviously. And he did spectacularly well, show some glimpses and everything like that, and he has the show potential to compete with against Liam Lawson and Jehan Ruvala for the title. Yes, when I say title, title for the Alpha Tower seat, because they need to upgrade one driver to that roster. But when it comes for Estonian first driver in Formula 1, I want to say there's one driver that should be in Formula 1 by this year, but in the end, he didn't do it. And that is Ralf Aron. Where is he now? And that's what we're gonna find out. So we're gonna start it up with the full name, Ralf Aron. And he was born in 21st of March 1998, age of 23 right now. He was born in Tallinn, Estonia, the capital city. And he competes in karting like the rest of Formula 1 drivers and race drivers, obviously, mostly. And in 2014, he managed to compete in Formula Renault 1.6, NASZ, NEC, Nordic, where the NASZ and NEC, he managed to be runners-up and just lose out to Antoine De Pasquale. Where is he now? V8 Supercars, the best racing cars in Australia and possibly the world. And he did alright, to be honest. We move on to the biggest step of Ralf Aron's career, and that is Formula 4, Italian and ADAC. When I say ADAC, it's German Formula 4, obviously. Where he competed with Prema Power Team, the ultimate team. And his teammate was none other than Guanyu and the unknown Giuliano Rocci. And this one, Ralf Aron managed to get the best out of it. In Italian Formula 4, he managed to get first place in the standings. The champion. He wins 9 races, 7 pole positions, 6 fast laps, and 13 podiums in total. And that is not a bad fleet, to be honest. A great one. He already beaten up the likes of, like I said before, Guangzhou to the runners-up. Robert Schwartzman, yeah! The next one is David Beckman. And that's not bad fleet at all. And also Marino Sato in 10th place. Done. Well, in ADAC Formula 4, he managed to get 1 win. And 2 fastest laps and 4 podiums managed to get 10th place. But ADAC Formula 4 is not a priority, so in the end, Italian Formula 4 is the main focus on this one. And the next one, he step up to 2016, the FIA Formula 3 European Championship. Joined the same team again with Prema Power Team, while they like the teammates of Lance Stroll, yes, Nick Cassidy and Maximilian Gunther. And he was among the rookies and sadly for him, he lost out to all of the three. Lance Stroll is the champion, Maximilian Gunther is the runners-up, and Nick Cassidy in 4th place. That's it, not bad fleet to be honest for all the Prema Power Team drivers. But for Ralf Aron itself, he sadly only managed to get 1 win and 2 podiums, that's all. 7th place in total. But obviously, okay, it's his rookie years, he needs to adapt more on this car, probably. And then he step up to 2017 with High Tech Grand Prix, where he competes and managed to get no wins, sadly. Only 1 pole position, 1 fastest lap, and 2 podiums. Sadly, only 9th place, and that's all. But when it comes to Macau Grand Prix on that season, it's the most weird, to be honest. If you look at this clip, yes, where Sergio Settecamara defending his win against Ferdinand Habsburg, but in the end did cheat on the wall, and that makes Dan Ticktum the winner. But the most shocking of all, in the end Lando Norris passed it, Ralf Aron almost lose out to the podium against Habsburg by some seconds, milliseconds to be honest, and puts him right now in 3rd place. That's not bad at all, lucky. But when it comes to 2018, it's the showtime, last time. Because in that season, he already probably the oldest one, the more experienced one. So he needs to put up the step on the plate on that one. He rejoined the same team again, Prema Power Team, the most dominant team. And he already get experience. He should be in top 3 at least, or top 5. And his teammates, oh my god, the best of the best. and that is Mick Schumacher, Robert Schwartzman, Marcus Armstrong, and Guanyu Zhou. But sadly for him, Ralf Aron didn't make it to top 5. Yeah, sadly for him, he managed to get 6th, almost one position behind. He only managed to get 4 wins, 2 fast laps, and 8 podiums. That's massive improvement, but he didn't make it to the top 5. He loses out to the eventual champion, Mick Schumacher. Runners up of the series, Dan Ticktum itself lose out. 3rd place is Robert Schwartzman. And 4th place is his compatriot, Yuri Vips. And I said before, at that time, I thought Yuri Vips, yeah, he's still young. But I believe Ralf Aron, with his experience, should be managed to get that Prema to be on top 5. Beat up Yuri Vips in the end. But sadly, it didn't come to fruition. So, goes on and goes on. And number 5 is Marcus Armstrong. So that's it. That's his Formula career. That's all. Because in the end, after testing in Formula 2 with Campos and Super Formula with Team Le Mans, he didn't race at all after that. Really, didn't compete till now, and officially, he's retired. But in the end, Ralf Aron studies in International Management Finance 4-year course at Franklin University of Switzerland. And in the end, he works with Prema to a team manager position. That's not bad a fleet at all. Good one, to be honest, where he competes and helping the team to moving forward. Because it's very rare to get some drivers to be involved in team management in the end. And now we're hoping up in Yuri Vips, where he almost in reach of a Formula 1 seat. And the youngest one, and that is his brother, and that is Paul Aron. We expect them to be in Formula 1 by the next 1 year for Yuri Vips, or maybe 5 years or 4 years for Ralf Aron. So thank you so much for watching this video. Yes, thank you so much. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Turn on the notification below if you want to. And follow my social media, Instagram and Twitter at RTHVir. And that's all for guys for today. See you in the next video. Alright, ciao.